Hi, this is Adam Gussow from Satan and Adam, and I've got a treat for you today. We're going to take on a song that expands the boundaries of the 12-bar blues a little bit. It's called Watermelon Man, and I learned it, actually, from a CD called Taken Off by Herbie Hancock. And what I'm going to do today is I'm going to actually play along a little bit with the CD, and then I'm going to talk to you about Watermelon Man. I'll tell you a story about it, too. All right, hold on. I'm not the spring chicken I used to be. Anyway, so let's talk a little bit about this song. Now, the first thing I want to do is I'm going to go back through it with you, and I'm going to help you count through it. But before you go anywhere, we want to talk a little bit about what to do when presented with a new song. So I said that I'm going to take the CD out of the CD player, and I'm going to show it to you. So what happened was, one night, Mr. Satan and I, here it is, Taken Off, Herbie Hancock, and I want you guys to all go out, buy the CD. Watermelon Man is the very first cut. See that, Watermelon Man? You're going to go out and you're going to buy it so that I don't get caught for copyright infringement. All right, so one night we're playing Finian's Rainbow, a little club on St. Mark's Place between 2nd and 3rd Avenue in New York, and we just kind of like started the song, and I realized we actually played some version of it, but I was playing it from some little distant memory of it. I'd never actually sat down and woodshedded with the song. So what I did after that night, I said, well, I want to go and learn the song. So I went to what was called Tower Records back then. They're all defunct now, up by Lincoln Center. And I went and I did a search, and I found that Herbie Hancock had done this song. And it turns out there's several different versions. Hancock, I think, has done several himself, but Mongo Santa Maria was the guy who did it, a kind of Latin jazz version of it that blew up really big in the mid or late 60s, actually. And there was a movie called Watermelon Man. So what I want to encourage you guys to do, first thing, is go out, go to iTunes, or go to Amazon, get a copy of Taken Off with Watermelon Man, with a sort of classic early version of this song, and then see if you can download Mongo Santa Maria. And then there's another version that has kind of whistling, weird Brazilian hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo, that kind of stuff, which is not the Watermelon Man that I'm playing. So we're talking about Herbie Hancock's version. Now, I'm using a B-flat harp. He plays it in the key of F, so a B-flat harp, cross harp, is what you need. And you can't play this song unless you do overblows, which is why this lesson, or this couple of lessons, is really oriented towards intermediate and advanced players who want to want to get a kind of bluesy song that's really, it's set up for the harp, although harp players don't seem to do it, but I'm a missionary here and I want to get you guys to do it. So what do we need to do? Well, first thing we need to do is we need to understand the harmonic structure of the song. Watermelon Man is, in fact, it's a 16-bar blues, but the way I like to think of it, I like to think of it as a 12-bar blues in which bars 9 and 10 are repeated two extra times. Okay, so when I count it in my mind, I'm going to actually count it like that. In other words, the 5 chord on bar 9 and the 4 chord in bar 10, that sort of, that cadence that makes up every blues song, is repeated two extra times. And I find that a lot of musicians, non-harmonica players as well as harp players, when I try to do this song in a jam session, have a hard time counting the song. They also tend to hold the end part of it too long. So we're going to count through it. I'm going to pause the camera, put on the CD, and I'm going to count you through it, right? And that's going to make all the difference when it comes time to actually playing through it. So here we go. So there's an intro to the song, which should come on momentarily. How about it? There's an intro to the song, and my ancient CD player is having a tough time finding it. So there's an intro to the song, and we're going to start by counting through that. 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4. So there's a 4-bar intro repeated twice. We're getting ready to start. Now listen to this. 1, 2, ready, go. 1, 2, these are the bars. 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, and now to the change. 5, 6, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8, 2. Now watch what I do. 9, 2, 4, 10. We're going to do it twice more. 9, 4, 10. 9, last time. 10, stop time. 11, 2, 3, 4, 12, and the turnaround. 1, 2, 3, 4. Seven, eight, running out of fingers. 9, 10, twice more. 9, 10, 2, 3, 4, 9, 2, 3, 4, 10. 11, 2, 3, 4, 12. Now listen to the solo, same thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3. We're on the one chord. 3, 2, 3, 4, 4. Getting ready for the change. 5, we're on the 4 chord now. 6, 2, 3, and back to the 1, 7, 2, 8, 2, listen for it. 9, 10, 9, 10, 9, here we go. 10, 11, 2, 3, 4, 12, and the turnaround. 1, 2, 2, 2, all on the 1 chord. Here we go, now to the change to the 4 chord, 5, 6, now we're going to move from the 4 to the 1, back to the 1, getting ready for that 5 chord, 9, 2, 3, 4, 10, so it's 5 to 4 to 1, 5 chord, 4 chord, 5 chord, 4, bang, 11, 2, 3, 4, 12, 2, 3, 4, boom, all right, hold on a second. Now, all right, so that you got a basic sense of how to count your way through this thing. Now, we're running out of time, okay? So we're going to have to turn most of this to the next lesson. But let me get you started on this. So the basic opening riff, what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the song acoustically, and then we'll move on to lesson number 2. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, ready, go. That's it. That's the lesson. I'll see you next time. We're going to come right back at you with lesson number 2 on this Watermelon Man. Bye-bye.